Hachette Children's Group presents Short, Sharp Shakespeare Stories. Macbeth. Retold by Anna Claybourne. Read for you by Charithra Chandran. This audiobook is an adaptation of Shakespeare's original play, retold for children, with a blend of original and rewritten text for accessibility. Shakespeare's plays often explore difficult themes that are key to the plot and context of the period they are set in. Introducing Macbeth. Macbeth is one of Shakespeare's most popular plays. In fact, it's one of the most famous and most performed plays of all time, by any writer. Although short for a Shakespeare play, it's packed with exciting elements. Witches and ghosts, blood-soaked battles, murder, madness and revenge. Who was Shakespeare? William Shakespeare is known today as one of the greatest writers who has ever lived. He mostly wrote plays and lived and worked in England around 400 years ago. Though his language now sounds old-fashioned, his stories are still as popular as ever. What's the story? Macbeth is a good soldier and a loyal servant to King Duncan, or at least he thought he was. But witchcraft, a power-hungry wife, and Macbeth's own desire for glory lead him towards a deadly decision from which there is no way back. Listen on to begin the blood-soaked story of Macbeth. Macbeth. Who's who? At the start of every Shakespeare play is a list of characters called the dramatis personae. Here's Macbeth's dramatis personae. We start off by meeting three witches, supernatural figures who play a big part in Macbeth's destiny. At the start of the play, Scotland is ruled by the kindly King Duncan. Duncan has two sons, Malcolm and Donalbain, heirs to the throne. There are also three Scottish noblemen in this play. Firstly, there's Macbeth, who is King Duncan's cousin. Macbeth has a scheming wife called Lady Macbeth. He is also great friends with Banquo, another Scottish nobleman. Banquo has a son called Fleance. The last nobleman in the play is Macduff, husband of Lady Macduff. Finally, like all Shakespeare plays, Macbeth has lots of smaller characters, such as servants, gatekeeper, doctor, soldiers, and lady-in-waiting. Chapter 1. Thunder and lightning crashed across the sky, and mist swirled over the murky moors as a deadly battle raged in the valley below. Scotland's forces were fighting off not one, but two fearsome foes, the Irish rebel MacDonald and his men, and an invading army from Norway. The Scots were outnumbered, but led on by their brave generals Banquo and Macbeth, they battled with grim resolve. Slowly but surely, they forced their enemies back. High on the heath above, huddled against the fog and freezing rain, crouched three dark, cloaked figures. Witches.
This battle will be lost and won by sunset, croaked one. Let's meet again at dusk upon the heath, cried the second witch. And there, on his way home, we'll catch Macbeth, cackled the third. Fair is foul and foul is fair. Hover through the fog and filthy air, chanted all three.
Wait, what does that mean? Fair means beautiful, and foul means horrible or evil. The witches are saying that good and bad will get muddled up and swap places. The witches gathered their black cloaks around them and vanished into the storm. In the Scottish camp, King Duncan waited anxiously for news of the battle. He was an old man, far too frail to fight. But his beloved sons, Malcolm and Donalbane, were both on the battlefield. Just then, Malcolm stumbled in, supporting a badly bleeding soldier. Father, he panted. This man saved my life. He can tell you how the battle goes. It's good news. The soldier slumped to his knees, but reached up to grasp the king's hand, eager to tell his story. Your Majesty, he whispered, we are winning. Brave Macbeth fought his way forward until he faced Macdonald, then slashed him open with his sword and sliced his head off. Ireland retreated, but Norway attacked again. Yet Macbeth and Banquo fought harder than ever. Blood flowed like water. The soldier was growing weak. As he was carried away to have his wounds tended, Lord Ross came striding into the camp. The war is over, Your Majesty, Ross announced. Macbeth is a true hero. He's just led our men to victory against Norway. Worthy Macbeth, cried Duncan. He must be rewarded. Find him at once and tell him he's no longer just the Thane of Glamis. I'm making him Thane of Cawdor too. All the castles and lands of Cawdor shall be his. At once, sir, said Ross, and hurried away. On the heath, the witches waited. Soon, two men in blood-stained armor came walking wearily towards them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.